Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. So one of the biggest changes coming with macOS Catalina is the iTunes app is gone, and in its place we've got the music, podcasts, and TV apps. So let's take a look at what the music app looks like in Catalina. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. You can join us and get exclusive content by going to macmost.com/patreon. Alright, so I'm using a beta here of Catalina, so things may change by the final version. If you look, you'll see what looks like the iTunes app icon. The icon's pretty much the same, but now it's the music app. So we'll run that. And the music app has a nice clean look because you can tell right away it's missing some of the features of iTunes. It's basically just focused on music. So a lot of the different stuff like podcasting and being able to rent movies and also being able to sync with your iOS devices, that's all gone and it's just focused on the music. So the first section here has stuff for Apple Music. And if you're an Apple Music subscriber like I am on my regular account, then you can access the For You and Browse sections here. We've also got the radio section, and of course there's a couple of free radio stations that we can all listen to, but the rest of it will be part of Apple Music. So that's the Apple Music section. Then you've got your library here. So you have similar things to what we've seen in the past in iTunes. You've got recently added. You've got an artist's view, which gives you a list of artists here. And then you can scroll through them all and see all the different albums for each artist. You've got an albums view. You've got a songs view, and this is highly customizable. You've got under view, show view options, and you could decide what you see there. And you can also, of course, sort in different ways. And you can click the header fields here to actually sort really quickly. So all very similar to what we're used to in iTunes. You can also look by genres instead of by artists or by composers as well. You also have the iTunes Store, a big major part of this. So the term iTunes isn't completely going away. It's still being used for the music store. And you can go and browse through the iTunes Music Store just as before. All of your previous purchases are still going to be there for you to download. And you can buy new music on a song by song or album by album basis. You also have the same Genius functionality that we saw in previous versions of iTunes. So you can use that if you like that. There's a lot of details here. For instance, we have this new view here for Up Next. So instead of appearing as a drop down menu at the top, you can now have this nice slide in sidebar here so you can see what music is coming up next. And of course, if you're looking at songs, you know, you can click on the three dots there and you can have it play next. You can have it play later. So you can add to your Up Next and kind of create this playlist as you go along. It's nice to have it here on the side instead. And you can also go to history and see what songs you've listened to that have gone through the list. This here is the lyrics. So if we start a song, we should normally be able to see the lyrics here. That works with Apple Music. Playback buttons up here, including the ability to be able to shuffle and loop through the songs. In preferences, it looks a lot like iTunes. You have the ability to have automatic downloads and sync your music library. You can also show or not show things like the iTunes Store, though that seems to be always on here in the beta. Playback, you can do crossfades and sound check and things like that. For files, you can set where the library is. So for files, you can set where your media folder is located and whether or not things are kept organized. This is all the same as in iTunes. So you're kind of getting this feeling that the music app really is iTunes with all of the other functions besides music removed. You have copy the files to the media library, so you can have files that are external just like before. You can store all your music on an external drive and turn this off and then have them added to the library that way. Import settings, you can still, when you rip a CD, you can still set it to all the different things you want. A lot of people are afraid things like that would be missing in the music app, but they're not. They're all here. You've also got the mini player. So you can bring up the mini player a variety of ways. You've got the mini player window here, and you can show Up Next and history and also the lyrics there for that. similar to before, you can just switch to the mini player so music goes away and you just have the mini player and you close the mini player and it comes back. That's all as before. Also, the visualizer is certainly still there with the regular and classic settings there, and you can turn that on just as you had in the iTunes app. A lot of people just assume that would go away, but it's definitely still there. You also can add to playlists. You can love and dislike a song. Also, if you like the old rating system, you can turn that back on in preferences, star ratings, and now you see that it appears there and you can actually rate your songs. To create playlists, you can go to New, Playlist, Playlist from Selection, and then once you have a playlist, you can drag and drop songs into it. So I can go back to songs here and I could drag a song into that playlist. Now I could also create a smart playlist as before. And you could set all this different criteria and it automatically updates. So all that functionality is still there. So what's missing? Well, in the beta, there's a really important feature that's missing. That's the ability to have multiple iTunes libraries. However, Apple has a note about this and specifically says this is something going on in the beta. So everybody kind of feels that this will be put back into the music app before the release of Catalina. So some of you may also be wondering how you sync music to an iPhone, an iPad, or an older iPod. And if you want to do that, you could still do it. It's not in the music app though like it was in iTunes. Instead, it's in the Finder. I'm going to look at that in a future episode. All in all, I think this is a huge improvement. It makes more sense to have a dedicated music app, have all of your local music, have Apple Music, everything there in one app just like it is in iOS, and leave behind the bloated iTunes app that did all sorts of different things. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.